In this screencast, we're going to discuss how to choose a reference state when you're doing an enthalpy calculation. So in order to calculate these enthalpies and energy balance, you need to set the reference state, in other words, the conditions where the enthalpy of that particular component is zero. Then enthalpies of that component are calculated relative to that reference state. In order to set a reference state, you need to put a temperature, a pressure, and a phase. And this is for every component that's in your system. How do we set a reference state? The first thing is if you are going to use a table of enthalpies. And if you're going to use that table to calculate your enthalpies and your energy balance, you have to use the reference state that's given by that table. Let's look at a couple of examples. Let's say you want to find the enthalpy of an ideal gas, in particular those involved with combustion at a certain temperature. You can either use heat capacities to calculate it, or you can use a table that has all the enthalpies for you. So here's an enthalpy table for the ideal gases. And if you take a look here, we have a temperature that's 25 degrees C. We have a reference pressure of 1 atmosphere. And notice that these are gases. For example, if you stated that the reference was 25 degrees C, 1 atmosphere, and N2 in its gaseous form, or N2 gas, and you wanted to know what the enthalpy was at 600 degrees, all you would have to do is look it up right there, and you'd find that your enthalpy is 17.39 kilojoules per mole. Notice, by the way, if you look at 25 degrees C, all the enthalpies for all the different gases are zero. Here's another example. If we look at part of a steam table, the reference is liquid water at the triple point. The triple point is the pressure, 0.00611 bar, temperature, which is 0.01, and note right here that the enthalpy for liquid water is zero. So the reference for the steam table would be water, liquid, at the triple point. So if we set that as our reference state, we can look up, for example, the enthalpy of saturated steam at 40 bar, right here, 2,800.8 kilojoules per kilogram. One thing to note is that the enthalpy for saturated steam at the triple point is not zero. That's the importance of setting a phase as well as a temperature and pressure as your reference. Now let's look at a case when you're using heat capacity. So you don't have a table and you are using heat capacities to determine your enthalpies. Because of that, you're not given a reference. So you can set one on your own, remembering that the reference state that you set is where the enthalpy of that particular component is zero. Then you can measure other enthalpies relative to it. So let's look at an example. We have a reboiler, and we have some amount of benzene liquid coming in and some amount of toluene liquid coming in. And it goes through the reboiler. we have coming out benzene and toluene vapor, as well as benzene and toluene liquid. And let's say that the liquid here comes in at 65 degrees C and exits the reboiler at 100 degrees C. We need to figure out how much heat we have to put into this system. The first thing we're going to do is put together an enthalpy table and select a reference. So again, we can choose any reference we want, but look at what happens when we set as our reference benzene liquid and toluene liquid at 65 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. Again, recalling this is when the enthalpy will be zero, and we're going to assume that the system is operating at 1 atmosphere. So take a look at our table, because H1 and H2 are at our reference state, therefore they're going to equal zero. And that means that's two less enthalpies that you need to calculate. If you take a look at this flowchart, it might help you when you're trying to choose a reference. This flowchart is a summary of what I just went over. However, what it doesn't take into account is what happens if you have a reaction. There are two ways to calculate heat from a reaction. The first is what's known as the heat of formation method, and the second is known as the heat of reaction method. Whichever method you choose determines what the reference state is. Let's start with the heat of formation method. Here, the reference state is each substance in its most stable state at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. So for example, if we had carbon, it would be carbon solid, H2 gas, O2 gas, etc. at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. What this does is it allows us to form our components, giving us the heat of formation that's measured at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. Look at it this way. Let's say that we have carbon dioxide with the heat of formation method, therefore using these references. So carbon and O2 have an enthalpy of zero at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. Then we form the CO2, and this gives us the heat of formation of the CO2. And then finally, we have our CO2 at 25 degrees C, and we can add to it any sensible heat or heat caused by a change in temperature from the reference. And note, because it's CO2, we can go back to our enthalpy table of ideal gases here and add to our heat of formation the enthalpy caused by a raise in temperature to 400 degrees C or something like that. However, if you use the heat of reaction method, then our references have to be the molecular species, again, at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere. So for example, the enthalpy at CO2 with these references at 25 degrees C and 1 atmosphere is zero. And then to get your specific enthalpy is just going to be the sensible heat. In order to be able to calculate your enthalpies in an energy balance, you're going to need to set a reference state. And depending on what type of energy balance you're doing, the reference data is either given to you so that you can use the appropriate tables, or you choose one that is the most convenient for your system.